there is a term, be it camouflaging or masking, that's often used to describe a large part of the experience of being a girl or a woman on the spectrum. I don't think it's just exclusive to us, but I think that we do it a little bit better. I think we've been forced to in many ways, because these social intricacies of female relationships are quantifiably more complex. It becomes difficult to know what being authentic is, because especially if you're not identified, you don't know that anything's different. So you're developing your sense of self based on hearing about deficiencies perhaps, or abundant overabundancies, but not understanding that your authentic self isn't something that is wrong. It's simply different. For me, that was the greatest gift of being identified. It was, okay, I'm not overly sensitive. I'm not under this. I'm simply different, and that is okay. In order to find a place, find a way where you can be yourself authentically, I think you have to first strip away a good deal of the persona, so that you can see what is underlying, to see what is not the mimicry, what is not the acting, but what is actually the authenticity. And then more than that, you need to have a family around you, or people around you, family by any construct, who support that. So getting to a place of saying, I need this, and not having folks around you who say, but for your own good, it's better to change. That's a beautiful thing. So I think in order for girls and women on the spectrum to be able to find that place of authenticity, they first need people who are going to welcome and celebrate that authentic person once she's revealed.
For more information about social and emotional learning, please visit readingrockets.org.